गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 12 ऑफ योर साइंस बुक, रिप्रोडक्शन इन प्लांट्स. ऑल द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स इंक्लूडिंग प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स हैव द केपेबिलिटी टू प्रोड्यूस न्यू इंडिविजुअल्स, एंड दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रोड्यूसिंग न्यू ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम द एग्जिस्टिंग वन ऑफ द सेम स्पीशीज इज कॉल्ड रिप्रोडक्शन. रिप्रोडक्शन इज असेंशियल फॉर द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ द स्पीशीज. We can categorize the parts of the plant into two, vegetative part and reproductive part. The various part of the plant, such as root, stem and leaves, each with a specific function, is called vegetative parts. And the part of the plant that participate in the process of sexual reproduction are called reproductive part of the plant, like flowers. Different organisms reproduce in a different way. In plants, there are two different methods of reproduction. One is asexual reproduction and another one is sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, only one parent is involved in the production of new individual of the same kind. But in sexual reproduction, the new plant are produced with the help of seed of a plant and two parents are involved, that is male and female part of a flower. Asexual reproduction in plants occur through various methods, and these are vegetative propagation, budding, fragmentation and spore formation. One of the method of asexual reproduction is vegetative propagation. It is the formation of new plant from the vegetative unit of bud, stem, roots and leaves, and these vegetative units are called propagules. Vegetative reproduction may take place using roots of the plant. Plants that have tuberous root, that is the root which are used as storage organ in the plant, participate in vegetative propagation. In order to grow new plant, these tuberous roots are sown in the soil. There are buds which are present on the root tuber that grows above the ground and a new plant is formed. Some examples of this type of propagation are seen in sweet potato. Next is vegetative propagation by stem. The stem or branches of the plant normally bear bud in the axil. The bud that are present in the axil, that is point of attachment of leaf at the node, develops into a shoot, and these are called vegetative buds. The vegetative bud can give rise to new plant. There are various methods of vegetative reproduction by stem. New plants are obtained from the stem by cutting method. In this method, the small part of the stem is removed by making a cut with a sharp knife. The stem cutting must have some buds on it. Now the lower end of the stem cutting is buried in the moist soil, and the upper part of the cutting having bud on it is kept above the soil. After a few days, this cutting develops roots. We can perform this method on rose, champa, grapes, sugarcane, banana and cactus, etc. Another method of vegetative propagation in stem is by layering. In this method, a mature branch of parent plant is bent down and covered with soil. The tip of the plant is kept above the ground and the root develops from the branches and grows into a new plant. Layering method is usually done in the plant that have long and slender branches like jasmine. Grafting is also a method of vegetative propagation in stems, where new plants of desired qualities is developed from two different plants. The part that has shoot part is called scion, and the part having root is called stalk. Scion is attached to the stalk, which provides support and basic requirement for the development of the plant. Grafting is done in apple, mango and rose, etc. Vegetative propagation can also be done by the help of leaves. When the leaf of some plants are buried into the moist soil, the cut edges or the margins of the leaves develop into new plants that resembles to the parent. For example, in bryophyllum. So, vegetative propagation by leaves takes place in bryophyllum. So, what are the advantages of these vegetative propagation techniques? Plants produced with vegetative propagation takes less time to grow and bear flower and fruit earlier than those produced from seeds. The new plants are exact copies of the parent plant because they are produced from a single parent. Next method of asexual reproduction is budding. In this process, a daughter individual is formed from the small projection on the parent body. It is called bud. And most of the fungi like yeast reproduce by budding. Yeast grow and multiply in every few hours if provided with sufficient nutrients and favorable conditions. As the yeast find favorable conditions, a small bulb-like projection produces from the yeast called bud, and the bud grows gradually and then get detached from the parent yeast. This new cell then grows, measures and produces more cells. Sometimes a chain of bud is formed, which leads to the production of large number of yeast altogether. Another type of asexual reproduction is fragmentation. Some algae like Spirogyra that are present in water bodies reproduce by fragmentation. In this method, the body of the parent breaks into smaller pieces called fragments, and each fragment grows up to become a new plant. Fragmentation of parent body occurs when they are matured. If water and nutrients are available, the algae will grow and multiply rapidly by fragmentation. If this process continues, it will cover a large area in a very short period of time. Spore formation is also a type of asexual reproduction. Some fungus like bread mold reproduces asexually by spore formation. Spores are formed inside sporangium. Spores are the small spherical bodies having thick protective wall that protects them from unfavorable conditions. When favorable conditions arrive, the sporangium burst, spores get into the air and germinate to develop into new plants. Spores are very light asexually reproducing bodies which can be carried over a long distances by air or wind. Some other plants like mosses and ferns also reproduce by spore formation. Second method of reproduction is sexual reproduction. The new plants are produced with the help of seeds of a plant in this process, and two parents are involved in this process. Flowers are the reproductive parts of a plant. They help the plant in sexual reproduction and producing fruits and seeds. Stamen is the male reproductive part of the plant. The stamen is made up of two parts, that is filament and anther. The stalk of the stamen is called filament and the swollen top of the stamen is called anther. Pistil is the female reproductive part of the flower that lies in the center of the flower. The top part of the pistil is called stigma. It receives the pollen grain from the anther during pollination. The middle part of the pistil is tube-like structure called style, which connects stigma to the ovary. The swollen bottom part of the base of the pistil is called ovary. The ovary makes ovules and stores them. These ovules contains egg cell and it is the female gamete of the flower. The base of the flower on which all the parts of the flower are attached is called receptacle. On the basis of type of reproductive organ present in the flower are of following types: unisexual flower and bisexual flower. The flower which contain only one reproductive organ, either male or female, are called unisexual flower, and these are also known as incomplete flower. For example, papaya, watermelon, corn and cucumber. In bisexual flower, they contain both reproductive parts, that is male and female, in a single flower. For example, rose, mustard and hibiscus. The function of the flower is to make male and female gametes and also to ensure that fertilization would take place for the seed formation. During sexual reproduction, male and female gametes fuse to form a zygote. But how male gametes reaches to the female gamete in plant? Yes, by the process of pollination. Transfer of pollen grain from the anther of the stamen to the stigma of the pistil is called pollination. पॉलिनेशन टेक्स प्लेस इन टू डिफरेंट वेज, सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन एंड क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन. व्हेन द पोलन ग्रेन फ्रॉम द एंथर ऑफ वन फ्लावर रीचेस टू द स्टिग्मा ऑफ द सेम फ्लावर, देन इट इज कॉल्ड सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन. सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन अकर्स इन बायसेक्सुअल फ्लावर. When the pollen grain from the anther of a flower of a plant are transferred to the stigma of the flower of the same plant or to the different plant of the same kind, and this process is called cross-pollination. The process of pollination is carried out by some external agencies like wind, water, insects and birds, and these are called agents of pollination. The process in which male gamete fuses with the female gamete to form a new cell, that is zygote, is called fertilization. When the pollens are deposited on the stigma of the pistil, it begins to germinate. After some time, a long pollen tube is developed from the pollen grain which passes through the style and towards the female gamete in the ovary. The male gamete moves down the pollen tube and the tube enters the ovule present inside the ovary. The tip of the pollen tube bursts and male gamete comes out of the pollen tube. Inside the ovary, the male gamete fuses with the female gamete present in the ovule to form a fertilized egg cell which is called zygote. The zygote develops into an embryo, which is the part of a seed that develops into a new plant. After the fertilization, the ovaries grows into the fruit and ovule develops into the seeds. Fruits are the ripened ovary of the flower, which protects the seed. Some fruits are fleshy and juicy like mango, apple and orange, while some are hard like almonds and walnuts. Do you know what is seed dispersal? Seeds are developed from the ovule. Seeds contain an embryo enclosed in a protective seed coat. If a large number of seeds fall on the same place, they will not get enough space for water and light and will not develop into a healthy plant. Thus, the seeds are moved away by some external agencies to far-off places. And this process by which seeds are scattered to different places far and wide from their parents is called seed dispersal. Dispersal by wind. The seeds that are very light and have wing or hair-like structure on them are easily carried away by the blowing wind. For example, seeds of drumstick and maple have wings. Seeds of oak and cotton seed also possess hair on them, while seeds of grasses, orchids, begonia are very small and light, and these seeds can be easily carried away by the wind and dispersed away from their natural habitat. Seeds are also dispersed by water. The seeds of some plants that have outer fibrous or spongy covering are dispersed through water. They have the ability to float in water and drift along with its flow. For example, seeds of water lily, lotus, singhada and coconut are dispersed through water. Some seeds are dispersed by birds. The birds eat fruits along with the seeds, and these seeds have hard outer covering. The seeds are dispersed to some other places through birds' feces. Dispersion by animals. Some seeds have hooks or spines which get attached to the fur of the body of grazing animals. For example, fruit of xanthium and urena. They have numerous hooks which attach to the animal fur and are dispersed with them. Next is dispersion by explosion or bursting of fruits. Sometimes fruits mature and strain is produced in the wall. This produces a sudden jerk causing fruits to break open and thus allowing the seed to scatter far away from their parent. Due to explosion of fruit, the seeds are thrown away from the plant with great force in all direction. For example, in castor plant, which bursts suddenly with a jerk and scatter the seed far away from the parent body. Fruit of balsam is also dispersed through the explosion mechanism. So what are the benefits of seed dispersal? Seed dispersal avoids overcrowding of young plants around their parent plant, and it helps in preventing competition between the plants and its own seedling for sunlight, water and mineral. And one of the benefit of seed dispersal is that it enables the plant to grow into new habitats for wider distribution and provides them with a better chance of survival. A seed contains a plant embryo in the resting state, which begins to grow only under favorable conditions. And the process by which seed begin to grow is called seed germination. When the plant start maturing, it bears flower, which again produces seed and fruit. And this cycle continues to produce more offspring to the preservation of a species. So this is all about asexual and sexual reproduction in plant. Hope you enjoyed the chapter. Thanks a lot.